Graduates, distinguished guests, faculty, staff, parents, students, families, and friends. This is my 10th graduation ceremony at Maeser, and every year we seek to make this ritual as unique as the class for which it was dedicated. We want to welcome all who are joining us tonight. We would like to recognize Mike and Jane Daniels, Kyle, the GM of WaterGardens, and our own Natalie Gerber and our awesome assistant Corbin Villa for helping us celebrate our class of 2021 with this beautiful visual graduation. In a few moments, you will see how our graduates have grown over the years at Maeser. Hear from our honor graduates, Tama Barr and Solon Grover, as well as our senior class representatives, Mae Manessis and Preston Weersdorf. Seniors, I am so proud of the way you handled your senior year. We recognize it was difficult, but one of the virtues we practiced and continually learned is perseverance and resilience. I used to pray for patience, and then I had twins and never prayed for patience again. But perseverance is a virtue we can all work towards. Despite the challenges this year, you have made it to this point and are ready for the new world of emerging adulthood. Look around you at this moment. You're surrounded by family, friends, and mentors who love you and are cheering you on as you seek your best life. What will that look like? Only you get to write that story. But follow what Karl G. Maeser encouraged, to be yourself, but always your better self. Imprint that on your heart. Remember us fondly as you conquer the world. Take the chances. Stretch a little farther. Become what you were meant to be. The program tonight will begin with a special presentation created by Ms. Gerber for graduates and families to celebrate your time with us. After that, we will be pleased to hear from our senior class representatives, Mae Manessis and Preston Weersdorf. Following Mae and Preston's address, Dustin Simmons, our Dean of Students, will introduce our Maeser Book Awards, and then our administration team, department chairs, or representatives will award those. Once these awards are complete, we will hear from Solon Grover, the 2021 Salutatorian, followed by Tama Barr, the 2021 Valedictorian. After our senior addresses, we will feature the reading of our graduate names.
In that 12 passenger van in a small club in Minnesota, and the snow outside of First Ave. I just wanted my name and a star. Now look at where we at, still growing up, still growing up. I would lay in my bed and dream about what I've become. Couldn't wait to get older, couldn't wait to be some. Now that I'm here, wishing I was still young. Those good old days.
I wish somebody would have told me, babe. Someday these will be the good old days. All the love you won't forget, and all these reckless nights you won't regret. Cause someday soon your whole life's gonna change. You'll miss the magic of the good old days.
Wish I didn't think I had the answers. Wish I didn't drink all of that glass first. Wish I made it to homecoming. Got up the courage to ask her. Wish I would've gotten out of my show. Wish I put the bottle back on that shelf. Wish I wouldn't have worried about what other people thought and felt comfortable with myself. Rooftop open and the stars above. Moment frozen, sneaking out and falling in love. Me, you, and that futon. We just begun. On the grass dreaming, figuring out who I was. Those good old days.
I wish somebody would've told me, babe.
Still young, maybe you always look back and think it was better than it was. Maybe these are the moments. Maybe I've been missing what it's about. Been scared of the future, thinking about the past while missing out on now. We've come so far, I guess I'm proud. And I ain't worried about the wrinkles around my smile. I got some scars, I've been around. I felt some pain, I've seen some things, but I'm here now. Those good old days.
You don't know what you got till it goes, till it's gone. You don't know what you got till it goes, till it's gone. I wish somebody would have told me, good old days, all the love you forget, and all these reckless nights you regret. Someday soon your whole life's gonna change. You'll miss the magic of these good old days.
Well, I'm going to Idaho, the potato capital of the U.S. I'm going to BYU for school there in the fall. I haven't even met the girls I'll be living with. I don't know how I feel about a house full of strangers. Two of my sisters have gone to college before me. Sabrina, the oldest, she's in Idaho. Haley is attending BYU Provo. The girls, of course, are doing fine. They have it figured out. Oh, it's scary, but it's exciting too. Now tell you what though, and I know you won't think well of me for it, but I almost want to leave high school.
My troubles all behind.
My troubles all behind.
I climbed on
Mom's the reason that I'm graduating. She's definitely graduating too.
To Maeser teachers, faculty, and administration, namely Mrs. Ellis, Mr. Simmons, and especially Gerbs, thank you for moving mountains and making this graduation possible. You have all inspired us daily in redefining our standards and in helping us discover who we are and who we want to become. Not only have you taught us the value of hard work and discipline, you have shown us what it means to live truthfully, honorably, and virtuously.
We, of course, wouldn't be here without the help of our parents. Thank you for your constant love and support you have shown us individually and as a class. Thank you for the countless rides, sleepless nights, and helping us with school projects. We know we can be a piece of work sometimes, but the lessons you've taught us have helped us in ways you can't imagine.
We've walked around our school for many years seeing gifts from past classes. As senior class co-presidents, it is our honor to present the senior class gift. We leave Maeser with a rug for the front hallway with our school logo and class year.
We give this in hopes of it symbolizing the Maeser community and what it means to be part of the pride. To the class of 2021, our heart has always been with you, but it is with you even more tonight as we embark on our new chapter and the rest of our lives. Look around at each other. On any side of you, you see someone who in some way has changed you and is a face you'll remember forever.
We have an Edwin Castillo who broke the window freshman year, has the funniest kiss stories, has hips better than Shakira, and an accent that he 100% uses as a chick magnet. The world only dreams of meeting someone like Rayleigh Peterson, whose love and kindness is too great for any human to comprehend.
How about a Devin Giles, who will put, without a doubt, a big smile on your face whenever you talk to him? Try a Tama Barr, that is the future Einstein, and has the bravery to do most anything. How about a student body president, who is a literal tree hugger? Everyone wishes they had an Amaral Shukarat to hug and talk to when the world feels like it's falling apart.
We've experienced the stress of school, the mess of relationships, but most importantly, memories we've made. Winning the Spirit Bowl fair and square our senior year, the life-changing Wintrums, Andy U hitting the same car 3 times the first day of school, zombies in Dowdle Socratic class, and the all-too-memorable and inevitable roast from taking Mr. Watabe's math classes, chanting "We're not last," feeding make-believe rage to "Before He Cheats," and the iconic hands-touching hands of Sweet Caroline.
We have been forged together as friends and as a class in a way no other class has. Yes, I am talking about when Mr. Simmons threw it back in freshman Socratic. We've learned and grown a lot, some more than others. We've had a lot of good laughs. We've had a lot of good cries. We've been each other's shoulders to cry on, and people that have made saying goodbye so bittersweet. Oh, we've also survived a senior year pandemic together. But above all, we've lived through experiences you can't put a price on for the simple fact that they are our own. Life is what you make of it, and that holds true for the rest of our lives.
We've learned and experienced with one another, but that was just the tip of the iceberg. While I hope we don't forget what we've become together, we're on to greater things now. From here on out, we're blessed with the challenges of finding a deeper meaning to life Viktor Frankl talked about, and finding our roles in society like in Lord of the Flies.
There's not much comfort we can give one another other than good luck, because I know we'll definitely need it.
To the class of 2021, we love you and wish the best for you.
Fellow graduates, my friends, this is it. We did it. Please join us in the Maeser Pride chant one last time.
Maeser Pride! Maeser Pride! Maeser Pride!
Reading is a fundamental part of the mission at Maeser Prep. Books are a window into the world. And so every year at graduation, we present book awards to those students who most exemplify this pursuit of knowledge in each department. This year, the book awards will be presented by department chairs or department representatives.
This year's Fine Arts Book Award goes to Christian Keller. Christian began his fine arts journey at Maeser in the 7th grade when his mother made him audition for Cinderella. And this year he played Friar Lawrence in our musical Romeo and Juliet, a character whose humility and fierce commitment to faith unites a torn community. In between, Christian has studied photography, print comm, Shakespeare, drama, been in choirs, and served on drama council. One of my favorite things about Christian is that he consumes art as much as he creates art. All art is storytelling, and we need those stories to learn and grow. Christian is a storyteller, and we hope he will continue to be in all of his future endeavors. The book I selected is How to Fly a Horse: The Secret History of Creation, Invention, and Discovery. It's a book that I recently discovered, full of lessons that I want to share with like-minded storytellers like Christian. Congratulations, Christian, and good luck.
If you know him, you already know who is the recipient of this year's Technology and Business Department's Book Award. And if you know him, you already know why. Congratulations, Corbin. I literally could not have done any of this without you.
The counseling department chose John Colby for the Book Award. John Colby is a force to be reckoned with. There have been many times over the past years that I have seen John wrestle with himself to push through hard things. I know that it couldn't have been easy for him, but he didn't give up. I am proud of him for never giving up, for pushing through and crossing this finish line. I believe in you, John Colby. My hope for you is that you will continue to push through hard things, that you will find the good in the world around you, and that you will believe in yourself. There is a great, big, beautiful world out there waiting for you. Congratulations on all your efforts and hard work. It has paid off.
Edwin Castillo entered Maeser's Spanish program with a bit of an advantage, having spent the first years of his life in Mexico and having grown up speaking Spanish in his home. Perhaps in large part because of that, he never had to struggle too much to receive good grades in Spanish class. However, he was not elected for the Foreign Language Department Book Award because of his Spanish grades. This would be an easy class for him to just brush off and forget about while at home, but he was elected for this award because of his commitment to not only getting good grades and learning the Spanish language, but to also embracing the literature, rhythms, and other beautiful pieces of Latino culture and actively singing them out in and out of the classroom. Foreign language classes are about much more than memorizing vocabulary and grammar tenses. It is every foreign language teacher's hope that students will gain an added measure of empathy and appreciation for world cultures throughout the course of their studies, and Edwin is one of our Maeser students who has demonstrated that added measure of empathy and appreciation for world cultures as he has sought to learn more about his own heritage. For these and many other reasons, the Foreign Language Department is pleased to present Edwin with a copy of an anthology of Pablo Neruda's poems in conjunction with this award. Congratulations, Edwin, and good luck with your future endeavors.
This year's Math Book Award recipient has been, without doubt, the top performer in math all 6 years at Maeser. One teacher states, "I remember having this student as a seventh grade in an eighth grade math class. More than once she asked me a question or posed a possible solution that either stumped me or really made me think. At the time I remember thinking, if this girl is thinking at this level, as a seventh grader, what is she going to be able to do in the future? She then took ninth grade math over the summer so she could be ready for 10th grade math as an eighth grader, and she's never looked back. Throughout this time, she has exhibited an exceptional spirit of humility along with a tenacious yearning to learn. Her humility and tenacity to learn, I believe, is her secret to learning so quickly at such a deep level. Since I had the privilege of teaching this student last 3 or 4 years, I too have a few words to say about this exceptional student, the recipient of this year's Math Book Award, Tama Barr. Tama is an ambitious, intelligent, and hardworking student. She's always enthusiastic and thorough in learning. I really admire the way Tama thinks and expresses her ideas as well as her obvious interest in math. She loves to learn in and out of classroom situation. She seeks and responds positively to ideas for making improvements. She has an ability to integrate the material, and her insights and comments always add depth to our class discussions. She has demonstrated an aptitude and an interest that could easily lead her to a career in math-related studies. Tama is not content with mediocrity and would spend hours trying to understand and integrate concepts introduced to her in class. She's a thoughtful and dedicated math student who is steadily opening up and sharing her sharp observations. While many students are satisfied with basic mastery of concept, Tama consistently strives to achieve more, always looking for harder problems and a different useful representations. Tama is a bright, well-mannered student. She is polite to her teachers as well as to her fellow students. She's a caring, generous, and thoughtful individual that I have come to really respect and appreciate last 4 years of association with her. I thoroughly enjoy talking to someone like Tama, who is very intelligent, yet very humble and respectful. Her caring personality always shines in our school and helps others to have good and meaningful lives. She's a well-rounded individual with a wide variety of interests and talents. Congratulations, Tama.
Hi, this year's Physical Education and Health Award goes to a young man who not only works hard, but actively seeks knowledge to improve his health. This year's award goes to Tanner Heaton, and we've chosen to give him the strength training Bible, and hopefully he can break his record in the deadlift. Each year, the science department chooses a student that has clearly shown what it means to be a scientist. A scientist is curious about how the world works. A scientist makes connections between what they already know and what they see now. A scientist makes observations and hypotheses. A scientist thinks critically about how and why phenomena occur. A scientist makes decisions based not just on the can we do something, but on the realization that sometimes it should also be about the should we do something. True and really good scientists are concerned about the impacts that technology, research, and discovery have on the entire world. This year's Science Book Award goes to a student who is not just really, really good at science, but practices ethics and integrity in everything she does. She's an amazing scientist, an amazing person. I am so honored and proud to award this year's Science Book Award to one of my favorite all-time students, Miss Mia Bradshaw. Mia, you're getting the science book. It tells everything you need to know about the world and how it works.
The Socratic Book Award goes to Tori Nielsen. Victoria Ashland Nielsen, confident thinker, not afraid to interject her opinion even if it differs from everyone else's, logical and analytical. Ask her to read a document and she will find the holes in its reasoning. Accomplished. Almost every time I opened up Google Classroom, Victoria's work was the first turned in. Generous. When asked to read fellow student essays and comment, she often read them all, with comments always pointing out the strong points of the author. Tori. Playful. She will often laugh at her own words. Quick. After someone makes a joke, she's the first to smile or snicker. Fearless. Gives and receives in equal measure. Interesting and passionate. Just start talking about Euclid's Elements or Cicero. Congratulations, Tori.
Welcome, friends, to our day of graduation. During the last few months at Maeser, we've all undoubtedly begun to take on the speech of old people, thinking to ourselves, wow, I can't believe it's over. It feels like everything has happened so quickly. Well, I'm here to tell you, no, it actually did not happen quickly. This journey has actually taken a very, very long time. For many of us, it has been a 4, 5, or even 6 year stay at our mythical and beloved Billard Building. We have received nearly a 50% gain in our number of years lived on Earth, and a million experiences to go with them, each one contributing to the complex and exciting personalities we have developed. All right now, what exactly were these experiences, and what kinds of people have resulted from them? Personally, one of my favorite memories happened back in Woolley's 9th grade Socratic. Those of you who took his class probably remember that catching frostbite or hypothermia was a legitimate concern you had upon entering his room, regardless of whatever seasonal weather existed outside. One day, my associates and I of the back corner eventually discovered that by running CPU-intensive activities on a Chromebook, like simultaneously playing dozens of YouTube videos and I.O. games, you could get the battery to heat up to a level which could restore movement to your frozen fingers. In this way, we were able to more easily navigate the tundra ecosystem of the second floor and survive to continue our education in the coming classes. Though some of us did not have the privilege of living through a 21st century Siberian gulag, we each have collected many of our own memories and stories equal to or surpassing in respect to the amusement of this one. But what about all the memories that are not quite so fun to relive, the ones we have tried earnestly to repress and forget? How many of us at some point have gotten into bed Sunday night just to be slammed with adrenaline at the realization of a report, paper, or heavy reading assignment due the next day? How many of us waited until the last 10 minutes of a Socratic circle discussion to give an impromptu, nonsensical speech to save our grade? Or how about standing in front of the class and attempting to improvise as your blank section of the group slideshow presentation appears on the projector? As we have by now discovered, an authentic high school experience is impossible without some of these. In the Calvin and Hobbes comic strip, the main character, Calvin, will often confront his dad about some of the chores and activities he's forced to participate in, like shoveling snow, camping, or eating strange dinners. The punchline of the joke is usually that Calvin's dad will give a dichotomy of possible outcomes. Either Calvin will enjoy what he does, or he'll build character. Of course, as a six-year-old, Calvin doesn't ever find this response to be sufficient, and will usually just dwell on whatever negative scenario he's managed to come up with. As new young adults, it can be incredibly advantageous for us to look upon the events of our lives with the kind of maturity that Calvin's dad has. Under this lens, it's easier to see setbacks, mistakes, tragedies, personal trials, and public embarrassments as opportunities for growth and greater understanding of the self. Frankl and Martel have shown that your reaction and framing of your circumstances are the largest possible predictors of your fate. Whether it be in Nazi Germany, a lifeboat in the middle of the Pacific Ocean, or a classroom, the difficulties you encounter are a chance to test and increase the strength of your mental armor for future battles. A loss or defeat can only exist if it's treated as such, and we have the power to decide. This last year brought with it various unexpected challenges. Many of us were unable to do the things we wanted, and school life had morphed into something almost unrecognizable. It was tough, at times it was truly ugly, we all had our moments of sadness, but here we are now as some good-looking graduates. We've all faced a great amount of character building, and so I would like to congratulate us all for working hard to bounce back as greater people from these would-be knockout blows. In the coming years, we'll all be starting new adventures at jobs and schools with people we've never met before, performing tasks we once thought were impossibly large for those such as ourselves. It will take persistence and determination, and it will probably be useful to learn Thomas Edison quote, who once said, "I have not failed, I've just found 10,000 ways that won't work." It may realistically take that many attempts to improve your abilities in some things, but what's important is that each is a necessary step towards the completion of our goal. If you want any evidence of this, go take a tour of your Google Drive. A quick look at an old argumentative essay or a literary analysis is a powerful reminder that all those daily journal writes and sentence diagramming worksheets weren't for nothing. Maeser has been my home for 6 years, and I'm grateful for the camaraderie I've felt and the lessons I've learned from its teachers and students. Looking back, I find that the distressing moments, no matter what size they may come in, are what have really caused the slow formation of my mental endurance. As we continue on the paths of our own lives and face its hazards, we must be sure to remember what we have already conquered and the rewards that wait for hard workers. Thank you.
Graduation. This is it, the moment of change. Except there hasn't been one moment. We've changed throughout our lives, throughout this last year. We change slowly, little by little, and events shape us along the way. We can learn from them, or we can hide from them. No matter what comes our way, there is always a lesson to be learned, even and especially in this pandemic. Each of us has had a unique experience, but there's a few similarities. Online school, I think we got from it what we put in. Did we sit there, camera off, watching something else, waiting for that oh-so-sweet release? Did we tune in to Socratic discussions, as different as they may have been, to see each other, to learn from each other? Did we study concepts or deny their existence? From challenging times, we take away what we put in. We can learn study skills, perseverance, and so much more. We can learn the price of ignoring consequences or the sweet reward of learning throughout our lives. It's not about where we get to. We're all here at graduation, but instead we learn from the journey. Our journey is more important than where we're going. Throughout my time at Maeser, I have loved getting to know the people here, and unfortunately, it's taken me a while to open up.
One time I remember was 8th grade science with Tori, Talia, and me, 3 T's, all at the same table, and we talked. I started reading Mistborn because of those conversations, and that brought me closer to many of you. Throughout my time here, I've grown past silly misconceptions, including one from 7th grade Shakespeare. I've gotten to know many of you, including your insecurities, and through all this, I've found the type of friends who I trust to let my mistakes go, so I can let them go too. I've been able to focus more on the moment instead of stressing about the words I use. There have been many people who have helped us along the way. My parents have been instrumental in helping me and encouraging me. Siblings and friends have helped, although differently. Thank you for all you do for us. Thank you to all the people who I've done activities with. Frisbee has been amazing because of the people there. Choir is made by the people, and cheering for a cross-country team was one of my favorite things to do. And then there's our teachers. They do so much for us, and there's a few I'd especially like to thank. Mrs. Pott, your kindness has helped lift my days. Your help with class and math team has made a difference. Mrs. Frampton, Mrs. Martinez, there's a reason you two are called Framptinas. Both of you have made a difference in my life by simply listening after class. Gerber, thank you for all your energy that you put into the yearbook and Shakespeare and so much more. To all of our math teachers, thank you. Thank you for your patience with us, with my occasional corrections and my stupid mistakes, for going through concepts over and over again. To all our Socratic teachers, thank you for helping guide us to principles and truths we will remember throughout our lives, and for teaching us that we can find truth through reading. To all of our teachers and coaches, thank you so much. You have made a difference in our lives with the kindness you show and sacrifices you make. Thank you to all the people here. Maeser is a community, a family, and so many people are part of that. Whether this is your first year here or your sixth, I hope you feel like you belong. Parents and teachers provide support, but in the end, this is our senior year. It's been beautiful and unique, and I wouldn't choose anything else.
Seniors, it is now time for you to make your way to the front as we prepare to award the diplomas.
Oh. let thy goodness like a fetter bind my wandering heart to thee. Prone to wander, Lord, I feel it, prone to leave the God I love. Here's my heart, oh, take and seal it for thy courts above. Seal it for thy courts,
It is now my pleasure to present to you the class of 2021.
Seth Aguilar, basketball JV captain, pharmacy technician, musician.
Amaral Shukarat, tennis captain, swim captain, 2021 Mr. Maeser winner.
Michael Aldis, Ultimate Frisbee Team Captain, Albert H. Small Normandy Institute Scholar, CNA, NHS, Vineyard City Youth Council, Black Belt, Eagle Scout.
Cameron Babcock, Space Enthusiast, Sci-Fi Lover, Baker.
Gavin Backus, and I participated in Mountain View Football Team.
Tim Abar, cross country, ultimate frisbee, Math Sterling Scholar, choir president.
Edgar Barrios, I play the guitar.
Joshua Beckham, Shakespeare, show choir, cross country, track and field, ultimate frisbee, and drama Sterling Scholar.
Lori Beltran, tennis, Mexican, Shrek lover.
Morgan Blomquist, blacksmithing, anime, music, and animals.
Maria Bradshaw, soccer, basketball, track, NHS, Family and Consumer Sciences, Sterling Scholar.
Haley Brown, music, animals, visual media.
Jackson Call, volleyball, soccer, basketball.
Fiorella Capella, Amy's Taekwondo black belt, martial art instructor, national referee, and ultimate frisbee player.
Matthew Carr, varsity soccer captain and middle school boys assistant coach.
Edwin Castillo, senior class vice president, soccer, Broadway rocks, theater, dancing, singing, Disney fanatic, dating fanatic, and animal lover.
Michael Chang, baseball captain, NHS member.
Kylie Chase, painter, piano player, visual arts, Sterling Scholar, true Maeser sports fan.
Aaron Cho, varsity basketball captain and track captain.
Adam Cho, varsity basketball captain.
Maddie Christensen, baseball captain, wrestling captain, basketball, track and field, violin.
Zachary Ethan Christensen, boys varsity soccer captain.
Jonathan Colby, Magic player, D&D enthusiast, superhero fanatic.
Elizabeth Cole, Drama, Baking, NHS, Youth City Council.
Malia Collings, Swimmer, Scuba Diver.
Tate Cotton, Broadway Rocks, Shakespeare, Swim Team Captain, Ultimate Frisbee Team, Dungeons & Dragons, and Brandon Sanderson Enthusiast.
Cheyenne Riona Davis, Volleyball.
Daniel Dodge.
Logan Dunyon, Show Choir Bass, Broadway Rocks for 4 years, and a proud Lion.
Harrison Gee, Baseball, Basketball.
Devin Giles, Science Throwing Scholar, Science Fair Competitions, National Honor Society, D&D Enthusiast.
Solon Grover, Salutatorian, Weightlifting.
Brooke Gwynn, Frisbee.
Marin Elena Gullidge, Track and Field, APR, NHS, Rock Climber, and Gymnastics Coach.
Rachel Gunderson, Student Body President, PrintCom Sports Editor, Instrumental Music Sterling Scholar.
Gracie Gigi, Varsity Girls Soccer, PrintCom Editor-in-Chief.
John Hall, creator of stories, reader, YouTube addict.
Kylie Hansen, skilled in technical sciences, Sterling Scholar, swim team captain, agriculture enthusiast.
Olivia Ann Harrington, varsity volleyball captain.
Tanner Heaton, Ultimate Frisbee, Computer Programming.
Marie Hua, English Sterling Scholar, Track, Cross Country, and 2 Mini AP classes.
Tad Hurley, Soccer, Ultimate Frisbee, Wrestling Captain, Baseball Captain.
Georgia Johnson, Dancer, Vocal Performance Sterling Scholar, Juliet.
Miles Johnson, Tennis Team, Shakespeare Team.
Christian Keller, Theater, Shakespeare, Show Choir, and PrintCom.
Susanna Lane.
Caitlin Lawson, competitive dancer, NHS president, Shakespeare competitor, Dance Sterling Scholar.
Hanson Lynn, track, sculpture, internship, and photography.
Chloe Lonaker, senior class president.
Anna Linsky, artist, potato enthusiast, theater, narwhal lover.
Pedro Martinez, basketball.
Emma Meekum, PrintCom Editor-in-Chief, Student Body Secretary, NHS Historian.
Maimonides, student council, soccer, basketball captain.
Cara Menson, orange cat enthusiast, pasta enjoyer.
Robbie Menson, soccer, basketball, orchestra.
Amberly Moon, dancer, singer, artist.
Vanessa Moreno, artist, proud Chilean.
Alexia Milstein, soccer captain, track captain, drama president.
Annie Naylor, aspiring artist.
Emma Nelson, basketball, ultimate frisbee, and major sports.
Tori Nielsen, Shakespeare, Latin Sterling Scholar, Romeo and Juliet.
Jenna Norris, volleyball, social sciences Sterling Scholar, senior class secretary.
Jonathan Olson. Corinna Owens. Aubrey Paxton.
Joshua Paz, beginner photographer, D&D enthusiast.
Alex Perry, art, swimming, astronomy, Spider-Man fan, and D&D.
Braylee Peterson, student body vice president, high school girl soccer, track and field captain, middle school girl soccer assistant coach.
Ajnay Rash, Disney fanatic artist.
Maria Camila Riascos.
Sama Salah, NHS, dancer, lifeguard, bilingual.
Melody Sanjines Guzman, science Olympiad, NHS, tea enthusiast.
Sydney Seavey, varsity tennis, dental assisting, NHS, AP art.
Elise Smeltzer, PrintCom feature editor and varsity volleyball.
McKenna Smeltzer, volleyball captain, middle school volleyball coach.
Allie Smith, Science Olympia, medical trainee, Twilight enthusiast.
Isabel Smith, art, birding, volunteering.
Talon Squires, 3D engineer, electronics guru, superbike team leader, race car driver, Ironman.
Rose Hannah Stewart, medical training, violin, science Olympiad, and tennis.
David Stone, ultimate frisbee, guitar and piano, show choir, avid reader.
Roman Strom.
Talia Timpson, orchestra, basketball, NHS.
Mona Ueno, tennis for singles and captain, figure skater, bird enthusiast.
Corbin Villa, Printcom Ops Editor, track, cross country, computer science Sterling Scholar.
Preston Von Weersdorf, cross country captain, member of the swim team, soccer captain, promoted to class, co-president.
Charles Wood, tennis team, avid reader.
Robert Yuritsian, Princom People Section Editor, skier, entrepreneur.
Rachel York, baseball, drama, show choir, AP Art.
Andy Yu, math team, science Olympiad.
Today, we complete our time with you wonderful graduates, but your time and journey is not yet finished. Karl G. Maeser once told his students, and I repeat it for your benefit today, make the wise man or woman within you your living ideal. Create your own circle of honor and never move from it. You have been granted a unique opportunity to be part of a great family, a great school, and a great circle of influence. It is now your choice as you leave these walls and halls of Maeser to be your best self. We as a Maeser community are so proud of you and are truly grateful for the opportunity to have been a part of our class of 2021. Seniors, at this time, we ask that you please arise. Parents, we ask you please turn on your headlights. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to present to you the Karl G. Maeser Preparatory Class of 2021. Graduates, you may now move your tassels.
Now I can't remember how it goes, but I
Congratulations, class. We are so proud of you. May you always have the heart of a lion. God bless and good night.